My name is German Uritskiy. We are in Bob Johnston's lab in the Johns Hopkins University. So the primary focus of the lab is understanding how, as a cell grows, it has to make decisions about what cell it becomes eventually in your body. As a case scenario, we look at the Drosophila fly. And in the Drosophila flies, their eyes can have many different types of cells. And in particular, one of the types of cells can be one of two types. It can be red or green. Just like similar in human eyes, we have three different color visions. We have red, green, and blue. These flies have two. But at a certain point in time, that cell that grows up to become a cell in the fly eye, it has to choose which one to go, red or blue. So we're interested in how that choice is made. The way this research works is that we're trying to understand the very basic fundamental principles of how cells become other cells. And if we can understand that in great depth, we can apply that to ourselves, to humans, and see how our cells differentiate in different parts of our bodies. And a lot of diseases in humans have that problem where cells become wrong cells. So for example, in cancer, a cell that should have been a liver cell becomes something else and just starts dividing sporadically. So if we can understand that process very, very well, we can see how we can influence that process to stop it from happening. I'm originally from Russia. My dad is a physicist, my mother is an economist, so I come sort of from an academic background, but I'm the first biologist in my family. As I was growing up, I was really interested in learning. I wanted to understand the world around me to great depth. Like, I would look at an environment and I would want to understand how that worked. That was the why question was always in the back of my mind, no matter what I did. So I was fascinated by the natural world as long as I can remember. And just gradually, as you grow up, that just sort of builds and builds, and you want to understand more and more. And eventually, just documentaries and books don't do it anymore. You want to try to actually uncover something new yourself. So before I came to Hopkins, I worked for a year at the Catholic University of America, and there we were studying HIV. We're trying to understand how to potentially combat the HIV virus with a vaccine, which is something people have been trying to do for decades now. It's a very difficult problem. And when I started at the lab, I knew nothing about it. I just got the job. I was very inexperienced, but I get more and more experienced. And towards the end, what happened was I just accidentally made a very big discovery. Actually, right before coming here, so it was only 3 months ago. But I made a very big discovery in how the virus works when it infects a person, something that had not been known before. And that was a big breakthrough. And right now they're gonna publish a paper on it. But those types of moments that where you just randomly, accidentally discover something big is really great when you have that. For me, it's the why question, the why that drives me to do experiments. I wanna understand how this works. I wanna understand how everything works. Working at a bench by myself with the beakers, with the DNA and the flies, I can control my little world. And I can make anything I want. I can manipulate any chemicals, any experiments, any flies I want. I can manipulate that in my own little world that I'm in control of and see how that works. And that, to me, gives me a lot of satisfaction. So for a high schooler just starting out, if you're interested in science, if you decide that you think that's what you want to do, I would say get out there and get some experience. So go out of your way to find opportunities to either volunteer or maybe even get a job, but most likely volunteer for a lab or something in science related to see if that's really what you wanted to do. Because a lot of people sort of go through high school and go into university having no experience, they don't know what it is, and they don't realize what they're getting into until it's kind of late down the line. So for myself, I can certainly say that it really took me working in a lab to understand that's what I wanted to do. So I would really recommend giving that a shot.